What made you interested in low-grade serous ovarian cancer and to choose that as your area to study?
That's a great question. I'm not sure I have a great answer. So I was interested back in the, even as early as the 1980s, in serous borderline tumors. When I first started my training at MD Anderson, the senior pathologist there did not believe that borderline tumors actually existed. He thought that they were all really invasive cancers and there was no such thing as a borderline tumor. And he would always say, they're not really any borderline tumors, they're only borderline pathologists, which was a little bit humorous at the time. But what happened with that is it resulted in over-treatment of many, many women with multiple surgeries, multiple chemotherapy regimens for borderline tumors, and that was unnecessary. Once Dr. Elvio Silva came to our institution, again as a trainee about the same time as I did, we developed a joint interest in borderline tumors, and during the 80s and 90s began to study them, and we were most interested in those borderline tumors where they were associated with the peritoneal implants, because we recognized that that had a different prognosis than if it was limited or confined to the ovary. And from that, we then found that these women had borderline tumors as well as peritoneal implants on some occasion would subsequently develop these invasive cancers. And even some of the world's experts at the time, and this was back in the 90s mainly, but even as recently as 2000, were very skeptical that you could have a diagnosis of a borderline tumor and then later on have low-grade serous carcinoma. So we were able to demonstrate that, I think, very convincingly with a series of studies. And then that just led to the development of the two-tier grading system, where we wanted to really focus in on serous carcinoma and not be left with this amorphous three-tier grading system that we had for many, many years. And then that just led to the clinical studies, the observational studies, and then on to the clinical trials. So it was a kind of a progression of interest from borderline tumors on to invasive low-grade serous.
Well, we're definitely really, really grateful for all the work you've done for our community. And thank you so much for your time here.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it, Jane. Thank you. You're doing great work.